Good morning. I'm Hosley Old Cordoba, and this is a 69 News netcast. If you are watching 69 News at sunrise, here's a bit of what you missed. President Trump now says he will revisit the DACA program if Congress does not act. Yesterday, the president announced he's phasing out President Obama's Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program, but gave Congress 6 months to come up with an alternative before totally ending it. WFMZ's Maria Salazar has the story.
The Trump administration has revealed its plan to phase out the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program, or DACA. The program allowed undocumented immigrants brought to the U.S. as children protection from deportation if they met certain requirements. President Obama launched the program with an executive order in 2012. The Trump administration calls it unconstitutional.
The executive branch, through DACA, deliberately sought to achieve what the legislative branch specifically refused to authorize on multiple occasions.
DACA will wind down over the next 6 months. The Trump administration says that gives Congress a chance to pass a permanent solution. Senators Dick Durbin and Lindsey Graham say they're working on a bipartisan bill to give those DACA recipients and others a path towards legalizing their status.
I think the president did the country a service by going back to constitutional order in a way that allows a six-month opportunity for the Congress to take care of these kids.
Berks County Immigration Attorney Jacqueline Klein remains cautious.
We would be hopeful that they do, but it's also something that they haven't done in all this time that DACA has been, since 2012.
Klein says in the meantime, it's important to know that while no new DACA applications will be accepted as of September 5th, some can still renew one last time.
People who have their applications that would be expiring between now and March 5th are able to renew it one more time as long as those applications are received by October 5th.
And the Pennsylvania Attorney General said there are nearly 6,000 DACA beneficiaries in the state. In the Berks studio, Maria Salazar, 69 News.
One employee of the Franconia Township Highway Department in Montgomery County was killed yesterday after being hit by a car. Another worker was seriously hurt. It happened on West Broad Street around 2:30 in the afternoon. Officials say both workers were rushed to the hospital. One later died from his injuries. Police say the men were painting lines on the road. The driver stayed at the scene after the accident. A photographer caught this tense moment on camera in Jim Thorpe, Carbon County. It's a Reading and Northern passenger train as it clips an SUV that drove onto the tracks. Police say the driver of this SUV says he did not notice or he didn't see or hear the train approaching and at the railroad crossing. Now, charges against him are pending. For more local news, watch 69 News or get updates here at WFMZ.com. With the 69 News netcast, I'm Hosley Old Cordoba.